In this video, we're taking a look at a website that lets you make games that you can play online or in person that you can use for all ages and all levels. Sounds too good to be true? Well, it's not. Let's take a look. So let's take a look at Baamboozle's website right now. No, not that Baamboozle. Showing my age now. This is what I used to play when I was a kid. Once we get to the website Baamboozle, we can join for free just by clicking up here in the top right hand corner. Now let's quickly take a look at the pricing. So we can use it for free. That's the most important thing. But in this video, I'm going to show you the differences between a free version and a paid version. So $3.99 per month, that's pretty cheap. That's cheaper than a lot of other gaming platforms for the classroom. So on the Baamboozle website, we have at the very top, you can go to My Library, which is where all the games, folders, likes, and followers are. Games is where you can search for content created by the users on Baamboozle, so teachers like you and me. News is keeping you up to date with all the new features that are on Baamboozle, and there's a lot of new features that are out at the moment, and there's also a lot of new features coming out in the near future. And the blog, which goes into ideas on how to use Baamboozle in the classroom. So the first thing we see when we go to Baamboozle's websites is on the left, we've got games, folders, likes, and following. So for example, here I'm looking at all the games that I've got for my classes and folders. Now, folders is a premium feature. So if you would like to collect all the games into different folders, then you're gonna need to sign up for the premium version. Likes is just favoriting games that you are interested in and you want to use for later. And following is really cool because you can follow people that regularly make Baamboozle games, and there's a lot of material on here, so there's a lot of people making content, so this is a good feature. To search for a game, you can pop any search term into this left hand search bar, and you can put anything like present simple, comparative, superlatives, present perfect, or even search by vocabulary. So for example, transport, sport, food, and it will come up with a list of games that match those search terms. Usually just putting the search term is enough. I usually don't change the language or any of these other parameters. Now, the first thing that most teachers do when they get to this website is go straight to games. So here is the game section. Each game has a short description and an image that represents the game. You can see also how many questions there are, if the game has images, and also if it's a featured game, which it is because it's appearing at the beginning here. Also tells you how many times this game has been played. For me, this is important. If the game has a high number of plays, it means it's a reliable game. It means that you can use it for yourself. So if we click on this game, for example, in the premium version, then when we go to play, then we can have all these different options on how to play this content with your students. If we go to a basic or a free version of the game, when we go to play, these four game modes are not available. You can only play the classic Baamboozle. Now, in a moment, I'm going to show you how to play each of these game modes with your students, but we'll go and look now at how to make a game. So to make a game, all we're going to do is go to the My Game section and click on this little plus sign where it says game. First, we need to give it a title. Let's just call it test, and a description. Let's call it test as well. If you are gonna make a game, give it a title and a good description. Be a good teacher and help the other teachers find your game. Also, you can put an image that will also help teachers decide what kind of content this game is about. Okay, so we've got two options before we even start, is to make the game either question and answer or question and multiple choice. Now, it all depends on what kind of game you're making. Okay, so for example, if you did what color is a banana, then we would put yellow. If we want to make it multiple choice, we could put some more options and some more colors. For this particular question, like the title of the game, we can also put images for each particular question. We can also change the amount of points. So if it's a particularly difficult question, which this one isn't, let's give this 5 points. And once the question is ready, we're just going to go to save. Now, once we've saved this question, it's going to be added below, as you can see. and we can start adding the next question. After you've made the game and you think you want to change the title or the description, all we do is click on settings and we can go back and make some changes to that there. Once you've finished writing all your questions, all you do is make sure you've pressed save and this game will now appear in your library. Now, we can make games in both the free and paid version of Baamboozle, but with the paid version, we can edit existing games. With the free version, you can't edit any existing games. You can only make games. So let's see how we play the free mode of all the games on Baamboozle. So I'm going to use this as an example, months of the year. So what we do is we press play. We're going to choose Baamboozle, which is the type of game that's free to both free and paid users. Now this is from a premium version, so we can make up to 8 teams. We can create a grid. So questions, we can create up to 24 questions. We click on options. We have all these different options to include. So for example, emojis on the grid. We can hide the score. We can have a pass button. We can have a timer. We can add color to the grid. And also this is a big difference between the premium and the free version is that the power-ups you have for the premium version are a lot more varied. So the way this works is that you have two teams. And when students choose a grid number, they might have a question or a power up. We can also change the theme as well. So we can change how it looks for the students. And at the very bottom, we can either choose to play with no power ups, just questions. We can play the classic version, which is questions and power ups. Or we can play a version of the game which is better for young learners or for children, which includes the questions, obviously, but also just some more simple power-ups. If we go to the basic version, we can see we can make up to only 4 teams. We can make a grid size of up to 24. If we go to options, we can see that there are all of these options are blocked except these ones at the bottom. So we can still pass, we can still put a timer, we can still add color to the grids, etc. If we go to the power-ups, you can see that we cannot activate these ones because they are plus. And these ones are set to on by default. And we can't change that. With themes, you can change the presentation of the game, which helps, especially if you're repeating the games a lot. And again, at the bottom, we've got the same options from quiz to classic junior. In a moment, I'm going to take a look at how we play all of these different games in the classroom. In another video coming out very soon, I'm going to show you examples and practical ideas of how I use these games with all different age groups and levels. And I'm going to post it right here. So let's take a look at how the basic Baamboozle game mode works. In this example, I've chosen 2 teams, a grid size of 16. I'm going to turn the timer off for this example. I'm going to include the power-ups, so I'm going to choose classic version. Usually what I first do is I ask the students to get into 2 teams and I get them to give me a team name. And once they've given me a team name, I go to this little pencil icon in the top right hand corner and I can change the team names. I can also edit the scores if there's been a mistake with the scores. Once we have the team names, then I choose, let's say team 1 is highlighted, so they're gonna go first. They can either choose a square, and the great thing about including images is that rather than numbers, you can get students to describe what image they would like to choose. So for example, instead of saying number 3, the students are gonna say, can I have the cheese square, please? And if they're not familiar with what cheese is, then you could also get them to describe it. If you don't want the students to choose, you can use the play button, which chooses a square at random. So let's choose one. Let's say team 1, they wanna choose the motorbike square. Very simple, I would ask them to choose the next month. So March, April, May. We were using team 1, so let's click team 1 and they get 5 points. Okay, very simple. You just continue from the first square until the end and whoever has the most points wins. Now playing the free version of this game would look like this. You've still got 2 teams. You can change the team names and the scores. The students choose a number rather than a picture. And again, it would be the same idea. They choose the next month and press okay. In the free version, the points automatically go to the team that's taking the turn. You don't have the option to change to a different team or go to the next question. Now we're going to take a look at some of the newest features on Baamboozle's websites, which are these four new game modes, which are Memory, Tic Tac Toe, Connect Four, and Bingo. First, we're going to take a look at the Memory game mode, and to do this, you need to make sure that you've got images assigned to each question. So, for example, I'm going to use this food game, which is pretty simple as there's a lot of images of the food that we need to match. Just click on the images to try and find a matching picture. Let's see if I can find one during this video. Oh, okay, very good. So then those 20 points would go to team one because it was team one's turn. And as you can see now, team two is highlighted and they would start choosing the correct cards to match the images. Let's go now to try four in a row, or as I knew it as a kid, connect four. So I just click on this. We're going to use the food game again. Again, we have two teams and the students choose a number at the top, a place to drop their counter. So let's go three. Okay, this is a salad. Yes, and it drops all the way to the bottom like in the real game. And then now team two, which is yellow, takes a turn. And obviously the idea of this is that you need to get four pieces connected in a row, either horizontally, vertically, or diagonal. Can you do diagonal? I can't remember. The next game mode I'm gonna show you is again using food, and we're gonna go to tic-tac-toe, or noughts and crosses, as we say in the UK. And again, this game mode is exactly as you imagine. We've got two teams. The students choose a number. I usually go for number five first. That's what they say anyway. Go to number five. This is meat, okay? And the X would go here. Then the next team would choose another number. And this, again, I'm using the same game, but I'm using a different game, so the students are happy to review this vocabulary once more because they know it's not the same old game every single time. Now, this next game mode is probably my favorite so far. This is Bingo. We just go to play again, and at the bottom left-hand corner, we've got Bingo, and we can see here all the terms, all the words that are in this game, and we simply press play Bingo. But a really interesting thing to do before you start the game is to click on this card template. We click on this, it gives you this free PDF from Baamboozle where students can include in each square the words that they would choose before they play Bingo. And you can have all these terms on the board projected so that students can copy, or if it's an online class, again, you would share your screen so students can copy 9 words from these 23 answers. Once the students have selected 9 words for these 9 squares, then all you need to do as a teacher is press play Bingo. So by default, you can see the images and the word, but what you can do is you can hide the text or you could hide the image. What I usually like to do is hide the word because it gives the students that extra challenge to try and guess what the word is just from the picture. And as you can see, we go through each picture like this and students are looking and they're marking off the words on their Bingo sheet. Now, if we get to a point where one of the students has got Bingo, we can press this little star in the corner and
Bingo!
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 Bingo! I could press this button all day. So you can see there, we had 5 different game modes and we can actually use the same quiz or the same game for all 5 different game modes, which means there's a really good opportunity there for you to review, practice, consolidate vocabulary, grammar, or any kind of topic with your students by playing it through all these different game modes. So Baamboozle is amazing for when you're in class with your students, either online or face to face, but it does also have options for your students to study or practice this vocabulary outside of class. So I'm going to show you how we use it for that. So when you're looking at a game preview, you can see in the top corner in the URL, you can see a code. So it's usually between 5 and 6 digits. So in this case, this is 35789. And this code is unique for each game. So what you can do for your students, if you're in class and you'd like to set them some homework, you can send them this link or even just send them this code and they can find it on the Baamboozle website. So if we give this link to a student, this is what they're going to see. Now, we can't expect all our students to sign up and make accounts, but they can use these games without making accounts. And if you look on the left-hand side, they can still play the game, although it's only the free-to-play version. And they have these two other options, which I think are really good for students at home. So we can go to study or slideshow. So study here, it gives the students all the questions. And what they can do is they can go through each question and try and answer correctly each one. So for example, this one, we would see, okay, August, September, and the student thinks, well, this is maybe December. And they would click this little icon here, this magnifying glass, and they'd realize it was wrong, it was actually October, and they would press oops, which means they got it wrong. If they want to do this one, for example, September, October, November, if they got the right answer, they'd press okay. And they can see here that the percentage shows how many they've got right or wrong overall. Now, I've actually got two wrong, you didn't see it. I got two wrong and one right, so at the moment it's sat at 33%. So it gives students an idea about how much they know of a topic in a percentage by answering all of these questions. Now, if you want to share this with your students, perhaps via Google Classroom, all we do is click share and we go to Google Classroom. Other options are email, Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, for example. But I use Google Classroom as my learning management system. So I click on Google Classroom and it's going to give me all of the classrooms that I'm using and I can just click on one and share it directly with them via Baamboozle's own website. Thank you for watching this video on Baamboozle. Now you know everything you need to go get started on this website in 2022. Have fun playing.